Oh, don't stare. How would you look after eons in some ghastly crypt? Your people are rather prone to death. Mine are not. Yet when I emerged from my completely unjustified imprisonment, I found them gone. Our culture forgotten. Any trace of the world I knew all but obliterated. I must even hide my true face beneath an ever-shifting mask for fear you savages will attack me. That is how I wander this strange world. Trying to uncover the truth about a history you primitive people never even knew existed.
For my unique red skin and unparalleled skills as a general of the House of War, I, the Red Prince, was raised within the vast palaces of the fabled Forbidden City. I was destined to become the next emperor. But my ambitions suffered a bit of a setback when I fell from grace for cavorting with demons. Now, I'm exiled and hunted by assassins. But I assure you, I remain undaunted and as determined as ever to claim my rightful throne.
I used to be a slave. Kept under the thumb of the master, the bastard that made me hunt down my own kin. How did he do that, you ask? With the living scar you see on my cheek, this horror that takes no more than a song sung by Master Dearest to control my very thoughts. But now the tables have turned. I broke my shackles, and when I finally find him, I will make the master sing a very different kind of song.
Once I was a crusader for the Divine Order. I pledged my life to Lucian the Divine. The war changed everything. He sent me to save the elves I grew up amongst. I arrived too late. Lucian ordered the use of death fog against the Black Ring, annihilating everyone I once knew in the process. Now I'm a mercenary killer, one of the infamous lone wolves. And my next target is none other than Lucian's own son.
Thinking about someone I used to know. My cousin, the queen, in fact. A tyrant. I tried to stop her, but things don't always go according to plan. She cast me out to a forgotten island and made short work of my allies, too. Lucky for me, I was able to commandeer a ship and began a new life for myself out on the high seas. Aye, but I hear that the Queen is at it again. And there's something darker behind her madcap schemes this time. If I don't stop her, I don't know who will.
my life, I've been a performer, a musician, beloved and celebrated by all. But I have a secret. I'm also a playground for sprites and spirits and worse. The voice that rings inside me now is darker than any that came before. Almost caused a bunch of my fans to rip each other to pieces. But you can trust me. I've got this under control. Step one, find out who or what is trying to take control of my mind. Step two, make it sorry it ever tried.
It all happened like I knew it would. A single drop of source magic. And, like flies to honey, the monsters swarmed. The rabble panicked. The carnage began. And the Magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned. I was shackled and collared and sent to Fort Joy. I'd come here to kill Godwoken. But instead, I became part of their story.
So, still a bit groggy, are we? Don't worry. The sedative will wear off soon enough. Easy now. No need to hurry. Get your bearings and report to me upstairs.
Well now, aren't you a curious sight? If I'd had a mask to hide my bones as well as yours, maybe I'd still be walking around today. Where'd you get it? There can't be many curios like that in the world. Is that a fact? And your voice? You ripped that from them too. I've never heard such silken tones from a naked skull. Ha! Should have known it was a parlor gimmick. Still, you'd best keep that mask on. The living don't take kindly to seeing their future staring back at them.
Rubbish.
An animal sty. Freight or food?
Shaking her fluffy coat, the sheep eyes you balefully, her rectangular eyes like letterboxes to the void. With one sharp hoof, she kicks you right in the shin.
Did you expect a needle? Did you expect a needle?
Get me out of this cage and I'll make it worth your while. You in? Set me free, and I'll set you free. A fair trade, I should think. Your guess is as good as mine. Someone screamed loud as a banshee. After that, pure pandemonium. They never even told me what I was accused of. Just dragged me down here.
This again.
Before you can even touch the lever, you hear a sniff and snort behind you as the snoring Magister mumbles himself awake. One bloodshot eye opens, and then another.
Is my shift over? Are you here to relieve me?
Wait, you're no Magister. You're a sorcerer. What are you doing here, filthy scrounger? Choose your words carefully. My fists ache to meet a new face.
A clever story. I almost fell for it. Almost. I should have known there'd be trouble.
So much for a peaceful stroll.
Empty.
Good thing I needn't worry about splinters.
And ignore me. But you should know it's not just my freedom at stake. A gentleman among jesters you are. Give that lever a pull, and I guarantee we'll both get something out of the deal.
The prisoner's buoyant voice darkens as his gaze finds the sunken hollows that once held your eyes.
Ah, freedom. Tastes better than wine. I'm nothing if not a man of my word. And I did give my word I'd set you free, lad. Say your prayers while you've breath to speak them. The halls await.